You don't need an appointment, and you don't need to be a techie to set up and activate your Midco internet services. This video covers how to install the Hitron CODA-4582 wireless modem. To get started, you'll need these items from Midco: your modem, a coax cable, a power cord, and an Ethernet cable, which is optional and needed only if you're doing a non-wireless connection. You'll also need your own Wi-Fi enabled laptop, smartphone, or another device to connect to the internet. Start by looking at the label on the back of your Hitron modem. Take a photo of the label with a smartphone or write down these details: the default network name and the default key. This is your modem's default Wi-Fi password. Next, pick a good central location in your home for your modem. It's best to place it up high off the floor, in a spot where it can get good air circulation and where it's away from other wireless devices. Also, your modem should be near an active cable wall outlet. Not all in-home cable outlets are active. Now it's time to start plugging things in. Connect the coax cable from the wall outlet to your modem's cable connection. Then plug the power cord into your modem and into an electrical outlet. Make sure all connections are finger tight. If your power outlet can be turned off by a light switch, be sure the switch is set to on. Next, wait up to 15 minutes for the online light to appear steady green. When the modem is connected, the online light on the front of the modem will stop flashing and remain steady green. Having trouble? If your online light isn't on or remains flashing after 15 minutes, here are a few quick things to check. First, make sure you're using the coax cable that came with your modem, and that the connections are finger tight. Also, when you first plug into power, the online light should show a steady green. If not, try a different power outlet. Once your online light is solid green, it's time to connect to Wi-Fi. Remember the default Wi-Fi network details from the label earlier? You'll need those now. With one device, such as your smartphone, go to your device settings and make sure Wi-Fi is turned on. Find and select the default Wi-Fi network for your modem, and enter the default key as your Wi-Fi password. Next, connect to or join the network. You'll know you're connected when your device displays a wireless network symbol or indicates it's connected. When you do this, Easy Connect will automatically launch and guide you through setting up your own personal, secure Wi-Fi network. If Easy Connect doesn't launch, enter this address into your browser: 192.168.0.1. Select Enter or Return. Once you've arrived at Easy Connect, choose Let's Go to begin following along. Tell us what you want your Wi-Fi network name and password to be. Make sure it's memorable and personal to you, but difficult for others to guess. You can even make your network name fun and punny to share with your guests. Choose Confirm Setup. Review the details on the next screen. Edit if needed. Write down your new Wi-Fi name and password so you have it for your other devices. Choose Complete My Setup. Your modem will automatically disconnect from the default Wi-Fi network. Next, go to your device's Wi-Fi settings and connect using the new Wi-Fi network name and password. Double-check that you've chosen the modem's Wi-Fi network and you're not using your mobile or cellular data. Open your web browser and visit a public website such as midco.com. If the site loads, you're successfully connected. Need to get more devices on your new Wi-Fi? Just go to your device's settings for Wi-Fi. Use the new customized Wi-Fi name and password you created in Easy Connect to hook them up. To find device-specific steps, refer to midco.com/Wi-Fi support. What about a direct wired connection to gaming systems or desktop computer? Just plug the Ethernet cord into your modem and the device. You should be good to go, as long as you've already successfully completed Easy Connect for your network. But what if you're having problems getting connected at all? Here are some troubleshooting tips. Take a look at the lights on the front of your modem. If the down arrow is blinking and the up arrow is not lit, try to plug into other cable outlets. Not all home cable outlets are active. Then wait 10 minutes to see if the modem connects. If you've tried multiple outlets and both arrow lights do not turn solid blue, contact Midco support. Troubleshooting tip 2. If you see both arrow lights blinking in unison, your modem is loading an update, even if it's new. This can take up to 60 minutes, so feel free to check back in a bit. When the update has successfully completed, both arrow lights will show solid blue. That means it's time to go through the Easy Connect steps to set up your new Wi-Fi network and get your devices online. If those arrow lights are still blinking after 60 minutes, reboot your modem. Just unplug the power cord, wait 30 seconds, and plug it back in. Then give it up to 60 minutes for a complete reboot and update. Once both arrow lights are solid blue, go through the Easy Connect steps to set up your new Wi-Fi network and hook up your devices. And here's another troubleshooting tip. If you've tried everything else and those two arrow lights are still blinking, it's time to try a factory reset. With your modem still powered on, press and hold the reset button found on the back of the modem for 10 seconds. You need a pen or paper clip to push it. Lights will begin to flash to show they're restarting the connection process. Once both arrow lights are solid blue, go through the Easy Connect steps to set up your new Wi-Fi network and hook up your devices. If you have questions, visit our online support at midco.com/modem support. Here you can find modem resources and how to reach our customer service team via chat, text, social media, and phone.